For those who have studied film school, I think we all went through a phase, whether you're a film school or studying visual communication design, at one point as filmmakers, you all want to shoot a good short film with your classmate. And a lot of people say shooting a short film with your classmate is the end of your friendship. And I've heard some similar story from Ibrahim. You know, I actually want to dive in Ibrahim's story. I'm more interested in yours because I also destroyed my friendship after shooting my, you know, student project, but you just finished it.
Whoa, okay.
2 weeks ago, right? A week ago.
Yeah, right.
And
a week ago, yeah.
How is it?
Strong. Oh, man. first of all, I grew some white hair, so there's that. jokes aside, I think it's the learning process is worth it. Like, you learn quite a lot, like a lot, you know, but it's just a lot of stress and pain that comes along that learning, you know, and that's and I think that's how it's supposed to be, right? Like, that's how it naturally is, and that's how you learn. Like, there's a lot of stress, there's a lot of work, hard work and preparation that goes in with directing films.
Ibrahim, I'm gonna stop you here for a second. Is it worth it though, do you think, to destroy a friendship just to get this film done?
Destroy your friendship? It depends, dude. Like, it depends on the reasons and the situations. Like, if the, like, that's a hard question, dude. I would say compromise. Like, I would say find a solution in between, right? Mm-hmm. Like there's gotta be a way to maintain both. And there's gonna be fights, there's gonna be some clashes between you and your colleagues, right?
Classmates.
You have to compromise and you have to sacrifice some things and they have to sacrifice other things. And sometimes it doesn't happen that way. Sometimes you give it all up for the sake of the film. But that's how it is. That's how life goes, you know. There are obstacles and you have to try to maneuver and try to kind of work things out, work situations out.
So,
yeah,
Ibrahim,
how
do you guys figure out the money thing? Because when I was shooting the short film back in university, we had to use our own money. So did you get any sponsor or did you get to use the school equipment? What was it? So you were studying visual communication design. It's not exactly film school. But they, as far as I remember, they do have equipments. So you used some of your own equipments, but did you have to spend some money and use your own money on the project? How was the money going on?
So, yeah, like regarding the budget, so I'm studying visual communication and design, and it's largely focused on film, like a large portion of the department's focus is on film, but for our film, for our senior project and the film that we worked on and still working on, the budget mainly came from us, right? They helped us. I rented equipment from the department. I borrowed, equipment from the department before the shoot, and they like give it to you for like 2 days, and where you check in the equipment, you would get it, shoot your film, and then bring it back, and yeah, so they give it to you for like a couple of days, and then you'd have to give it back, and if you want it again, you'd have to rent it again.
What are the equipments that you borrowed?
So we borrowed LED lights, we borrowed the zoom boom, and all of the sound kits. We borrowed a diffuser. We borrowed the basics, right? Like, they don't have things that are exceptional. And to be honest, it's always a struggle to rent equipment from the department because you have to be very careful about the equipment. It's not your own. It's not yours. You don't want to lose it. You have to be very cautious and careful about how do you work with your equipment, right?
Plus,
because it's not yours.
Everyone is that was the period of time where everyone is going to shoot films, so it's probably very hard to get it as well, right?
Luckily for us, so there's the pandemic and not everybody's shooting films, and even the students who are shooting films are not necessarily borrowing equipment from the department.
Mm-hmm.
And some of them are shooting documentaries, so they don't need the lights, they don't need the the rest of the equipment. So luckily for us, everything was available. But man, I wanted to rent the
C100.
Mm-hmm. And apparently, so I had the approval from my instructor to rent it, and I wanted to rent it. I went to the thing, to the store, like the store to rent it, but they, so the guy who's responsible there, he said, oh, you have to get the approval from the chair of the department.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, screw that, you know, I'm not gonna do that. And then we had no time anyways to rent it. So I was like, okay, I'm actually gonna just shoot on my, with my cam, shoot the film with my camera.
Mm-hmm.
Right. It's kind of very close to the C100.
Mm-hmm.
I get it. Like the C100 has a bit more, it's a little bit better, but is it worth it? Like, and I asked you about this actually.
Yeah. Yeah. We did talk back about in the it. Day.
Yeah.
You shot with the A7S, right? A7S.
A7S Mark One.
And yeah. How was it to deal with the Corona while shooting it? It was,
oh man, it's a freaking struggle, dude. The main struggle is the time limitations, right? So we had a limited time. So for those who don't know, in Turkey, during this month and last month, during April, there were some curfews after 7 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
And so we couldn't shoot after that. So we had a very, very limited time. Plus, the weekends were curfews, so we only were able to shoot during the weekdays. And at the same time, we had classes during the weekdays and we had to compromise.
Mm-hmm.
to miss some classes. And there was a lot of things that had to be put aside in order for us to shoot. And in one of the days, actually, in one of the house interior scenes,
mm-hmm.
When we were shooting the interiors, one of the days we had to stay overnight. Right. Mm. So we had to, instead of leaving the house, because we cannot leave and go back due to the curfew after 7 p.m., we stayed all night, like until the next
day. You slept there?
Yeah, we slept. We didn't sleep, actually. We stayed awake all night. And
oh, really? Just shooting?
I went back, at 5 a.m. That's when the curfew.
It was Airbnb house, right? You rented
it? Yeah, we rented it. Yeah, we rented it for 2 days. And we shot and... There was that also, like you had to finish 6 scenes in 2 days, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, man, it's a lot of stress and it's a lot of work. But one thing that I want to talk about, and I actually want to ask you about,
uh-huh.
The thing that really bothers me with student films, and I think it depends from a group to group. It depends on your classmates and the people you're working with.
Yeah.
Is one of the things that really bothered me is morale, right?
Mm.
And... it's morale is enthusiasm, it's energy, it's discipline,
right? Yeah.
And I think this is one of the key characteristics that you need to have in order to make a good film, man. And I don't know how was it with your team, with how was it with your teammates and your classmates and the people that you were working with.
Mm-hmm.
But for my case, I didn't feel like the people who I was working with had that kind of a strong enthusiasm and strong energy and
mm-hmm.
kind of discipline in order, like, you know what, I'm ready to give up all my I'm ready to put in all my time and energy for this to work out.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't have that, and that bothered me really, really that bothered me so much.
Mm-hmm.
And so how was it in your case? Like, how was the enthusiasm, how was the passion, how was it, like, how passionate were your classmates and how was it in your situation?
I think the worst thing that a filmmaking student can have while they're preparing their own short film is the ego. The ego is like the worst thing, because we've seen so much students, they already have an ego of a Hollywood director mm-hmm. before they even did anything.
Yes.
And that's,
yes.
I think that's like the worst you could have. Anything else I think is, you know, you can still manage it in a way. Obviously, there's some other stuff that are annoying, but the one that I face the most are ego. Like, some people, they don't know exactly how it works. They think that, oh, cinematographer is just camera and they don't do anything else, or director king. So you listen to director and producer is like, you know, they get confused and they don't really know that there's a lot of gray areas. People, even directors, they collide some jobs with the cinematographer. They have to know something about cameras, you know, and cameraman should know something about lighting, you know. Some cameraman, they know everything about lighting. You know, you have to have these knowledge that kind of collide with other positions. You have to. And the ones that I met, they don't really know that. And another thing is that even someone who's very enthusiastic about the project, you have to make sure that you have the same goal. Not having the same goal is very dangerous, because you know, you might start all, you know, fun and everyone is so energetic at the beginning, but maybe in the middle of the project you will notice that something is going wrong. Like, everyone is so energetic, but you fight a lot because you don't have the same goal. So make sure you guys want the same exact thing at the end of the project. Otherwise, like, it's just everywhere. I'm pretty sure for your case, it's just everywhere, right?
That's what it is, and that's what causes a lot of trouble.
Yeah.
Right. And also, one more thing that causes a lot of trouble is the roles case. Mm. So I agree with you. I think 100%. You have to understand how the roles work, right? And you have to be practical, especially in a student film. A lot of people assume that on a student film, oh, like you said, like, I'm a director and I get to tell people what to do, right? And you all have to listen to me and I'm the boss. Mm. It's not like that. It's definitely not like that, because the roles are kind of intertwined and you have to understand everything and you have to compromise and help each other, right? Mm-hmm. If you're a director, the others can also help give notes to the actors and they can help drive this vision that you're all carrying together, especially on a student film. There's no contract. There's no...
Yeah. No one is paying no one.
Some sort of... Yes, no one is getting paid, man. It's all for you to learn and make a good product at the end of the day, right? Mm-hmm. And so I agree with you 100%. You've got to understand the roles and you have to be practical and help each other out when the situation requires, right? And you have to be passionate. That's when passion comes in, right? Like, I'm willing to give up my... I'm willing to give up my time and energy for this to work, right? Because I love this film and I want a good end product for all of us. And that's how everybody should think, right? And you need to have a mutual goal and shared and common vision, and you should all work together regardless of whether you're a cinematographer or an editor, or and even if you're talking about roles, and most of the times it's always multi-dimensional, if that makes sense. It's always people doing multiple roles, like for instance, I was editing the film, I was directing the films, and you probably were doing the same thing. You were doing multiple roles, and you just have to be practical. You have to think in terms of the situation and what can I do in order to make this work. That's what I think about it, at least.
What about the post production? Like, did you guys work together for post production, or?
I'm completely working on the post production right now. Editing the film.
So after
For us, it's the...
I'm sorry. So after working on these short films for the it's probably your first big project, right? For a student, like, the biggest one. After working on this, what do you think about your future career? Do you think that but you did internship, I know, but does it change how you feel about the film industry? Do you feel like, oh, the film industry is gonna be as messy as your current project, or do you think it's gonna be way better once you are working in the actual industry? What do you expect?
To be honest, I think in the industry it's more practical than this, and I feel like there's a bit more professionalism, to be honest, because people are getting paid to do their jobs, and I get it, some people might slack, right? And some people might not do their job well, but at the end of the day, students in general have a lower standard than what the industry contains, if that makes sense. And I think it depends from a company to company, it depends on the team that you're collaborating with. And there are a lot of factors that come into play, but I feel like, I guess in the job industry, it's more, it's more organized in a way, right? There's more responsibility. People carry a bit more responsibility, because that's their job, right? Like, what else are they doing? And yeah,
okay.
What do you think about, like, what's your thoughts on this as well?
I actually have a few tips, I guess, when it comes to doing your own project. When it come when you're a student, is what I did. Okay, I'm not saying that's the golden rule, but what I did is I tried to let the teacher not get involved too much in our project, because especially the last year. I remember the last year I fought with my teacher a lot, is because, not because of the ego, but I really wanted to see if me and my team, we could manage to shoot a short film without the help from the teacher at all. So the first year to third year, we did get some help here and there, but I didn't want the teacher to touch it. Not because I didn't want to listen to the teacher, but I wanted to know, since this is the last project I'm going to shoot in this school, can I do it without the help? Otherwise, if I enter the industry, it's going to be very hard for me, right? And I think I didn't regret the choice. Even there's a lot of mistake I did for the last project, but I think it is, you actually feel a lot more different. You feel like everything is serious, because nobody's going to tell you that, oh, you messed up there. You're going to have to notice it yourself. Otherwise, nobody's going to see it. Maybe your teammate, you know. And the thing is, I'm lucky that I have one or two teammates that are really, you know, professional, even though it's a student film. So we worked out together. We really tried to be as professional as possible. And I was really lucky, because we had this agreement that we're going to try to keep everything as professional as possible, even though we're putting out our own money and everything. So yeah, I think not try to do everything by yourself without asking too much question. Obviously, at the end, if you really still need help, you can ask, but you get what I mean. Yeah.
Yeah. So that was it. You're saying, like, have no expectations of others, right? And try to depend on yourself.
To
do a good work. Yeah. But one of the things actually that I really struggled with working with people is it is sometimes hard to think, articulate, and express yourself and tell people what you want. I think that's very important when it comes to filmmaking. And I really, really struggled with that. Not because of the language, but it's because of I wanted something, but I couldn't put that into words specifically for my teammates to act on it, right? For my classmates to act on it. And that's something really, really hard. And that's, I think that separates a good director from a normal director, or
that's a really good point because I'm gonna have to say it, because even in the professional environment this happens a lot, because so the directors and the creative directors I worked with, they use I think when you're learning script writing, they mentioned that when you're writing a script, you cannot use words that are too vague. You rather say faster, louder, you know. It's like very direct thing, not too much emotion in it, I guess. And I think it goes the same when it comes to directing. Yeah, and I understand this feeling. At the beginning, you really like, this is just not the right feeling, but you cannot explain what it is. But I think that's a really good practice, because I think it goes the same for everyone, for cinematographer, for maybe sound recorder, I don't know. Like, especially for director, you need to learn how to articulate yourself, and so that everyone can have the same understanding. Because when you're doing these kind of artworks, everything is pretty subjective, because art is very subjective, right? It came from your own emotion already. You need to establish a common understanding on what dramatic means or what scary means. If everyone has the same understanding, you get to move on more. So I think one tip is that you might show some reference to what exactly you're talking about. So if there's a film or a commercial that is kind of similar, you know, having the same direction as your work, show them that commercial and say, okay, this part is what I liked about it. Maybe don't do that too often, because then you rely on commercial too much, but sometimes you can use that as a reference.
I think being specific with your wording and with what you mean is a very good way to deliver and express what you want. But sometimes it's hard, right? And I guess there's a lot of, you need a lot of practice and a lot of work in order to achieve that.
Mm-hmm.
But also one of the things that really bother, that really I struggle with is how do you deal with situations when you're not getting what you want? Like you shot a certain scene or mm-hmm. a certain take, mm-hmm. right? And you keep shooting it over and over mm-hmm. and you're not necessarily getting what you want.
Mm-hmm.
Like for you, Kai, like what do you do in that situation? How do you just try to beat that scene over the ground into the ground and try to keep doing it over and over? Or do you just like let things slip through and try to, you know, like compromise in that situation? Like how do you deal with these situations, especially in your short film?
First of all, I want to ask what was the situation? Was it wrong with the acting or was it wrong with the lighting or what was it?
Okay. So sometimes the acting is not necessarily right.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes the shot is not necessarily perfect, mm-hmm. right? The way I want. Sometimes it's both.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, like it's always a mixture of these elements together.
Oh, okay.
That kind of result, yeah.
So there's two things that it happened to me before. One is the acting. So especially okay. for emotional acting, it's very tricky mm-hmm. because you want them to get into the character, but sometimes the more they do, the faker it gets. So
mm-hmm.
What you can do sometimes is if you're in the same environment and this shot is not working and you really need to get it right, and if you know you mm-hmm. have more time, just skip to the next scene and go like, change the scene and let them shoot something else, and then they refresh it. Refresh themselves a mm-hmm. bit, and if you have time, just mm-hmm. come back to the scene later if you have extra time. Mm-hmm. But for other situation, which this is really important,
mm-hmm.
if you're not getting what you want, you got to compromise. So you got to see if this thing is affecting the story. So the story is the most important okay. thing. So sometimes okay. there are cases where I just have to change everything because it doesn't work. So I have mm-hmm. to think directly what is going to help me tell the story better. So everything does, like nothing matters. Maybe in the pre-production, you said, oh, I wanted smoke. I wanted the lighting to look like this. These are all ideal plans. But at the end, okay. if it cannot tell the story in the best way, then you got to change it. So you got to rethink. Is this really the best for the story? And if there's other option, what is the second best option for me to tell the story? The story goes first. Everything else is just a support, you know? So yeah, that was a really good question.
So yeah. Hmm. You have to look at the big picture and think in accordance to that, right? Like, what is this small mistake serving this, like completely destroying the story?
Yes.
And if it is, how can I change it in order to create a better result that's going to contribute to the story better?
Especially right? for you as a director, you got to make the mm-hmm. decision because this is the time when nobody's going to help you. I mean, not that they don't want to help you, but this is the part where you make the decision because you're the storyteller.
Yes, it's so, all on you.
Yeah, and so you really got to express yourself very clearly and tell everyone that, okay, mm-hmm. we're going to change everything. This is how it's going to be. You know, go with things step by step. Yeah, that's the thing, man.
Yeah.